Hi, good morning, everyone.
大家早上好。
Welcome to our FCBC service.
欢迎来到坚信进行教会的聚会。
And whether you're from FCBC or you're a guest,
无论你是我们的会友，又或者是新朋友
，We're so happy that you've taken this time out to connect with us.
很开心你今天愿意花时间来参加我们的线上聚会。
Well, you know, we may be all connected online.
或许我们只是能够线上聚会。
But yet we're still together in this same moment.
可是我们在这一刻，我们的心灵感应啊，我们是在一起的。
We're going to be worshiping God together.
我们要一起来敬拜主。
We're going to be praying together.
一起来祷告。
And we're going to receive the word of God together.
让我们一起来领受神的话语，好不好？
So, do me a favor. Why don't we all stand up wherever we are?
如果你在家中的话呢，邀请你站立起来。
If there's someone around you who's attending the service,
如果你身边有家人或者朋友一起来看聚会的话
，say tell the person it's so good to have you.
跟他说有你在一起真好。
All right, and if you're by yourself, you can put it on our live chat.
如果你是自己一个人在家看聚会的话，你也可以在我们的 YouTube 线上的这个直播聊天室，可以写一段话。
If not, Paul and I will say it to you.
要不然我们俩就跟你说，有你真好，
有你真好，
有你真好，简单的一点。
All right, well, why don't we join our hearts together and pray?
好不好？我们心连心一起来祷告。
Let's commit this whole service to the Lord's hands.
我们将这个聚会交给主。
Lord, we thank you for this opportunity we have.
主啊，我们感谢你，我们有这个机会可以一起相聚。
Even though we're in many different places,
就算我们是遍布新加坡
，but we're together in the same moment right now.
可是在这一刻，我们是在一起的。
We want to worship you with all that we have.
我们要用我们的所有来敬拜你。
Lord, we give you all the praise.
我们将敬拜跟赞美都交给你。
And we ask that we will encounter you in a fresh way.
求主让我们能够全新的来经历到你。
So to all of you, I bless you.
我要祝福大家。
That you receive of his joy.
你能够领受到他的喜乐。
And that you experience that his joy truly is your strength.
你也能够经历到他的他的喜乐就是你的力量。
In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray.
我们奉耶稣基督的名祷告。
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
So let's come, let's worship the Lord.
所以好不好，我们一起来敬拜。
有你在一起，敬拜主真好。
Amen。
我们一起来宣告，这是耶和华所定的日子，
这是耶和华所定日子，神的儿女当欢呼喜乐。耶和华一战胜仇敌，一战胜仇敌，全地大声欢呼，这是耶和华所定日子，神的儿女当欢呼喜乐。求你一战胜，求你全地大声欢呼。耶和华是我力量，我心中一切的盼望。耶和华是我的诗歌，又是我的成就。神子民心走全力，把好消息宣告你的名，高举的手的旗旗，我们称。
是的，我们的神真伟大，真美好 ，Amen。
Amen。
Amen。神的话语告诉我们，敌人是来偷抢，是来杀害，也是来破坏。可是我们的主，我们的神是来的是要给我们丰盛的生命。所以呢，今天无论我们遇到的是什么困难，我们都可以来大大的赞美主，因为我们的主是我们的牧者，他都在我们的旁边，他都在我们的身边。Amen。
缺乏，使我躺卧青草地，在安歇的水边。他使我灵魂苏醒，引我走正义路。我虽过死荫幽谷，也必不怕遭害。在我敌人面前，为我摆设筵席。
我们的双手，我们敞开我们的心。主啊，我们谢谢你给了我们这么伟大的爱。神伟大的爱。
气场扩高声，进步灵犀他独生爱子，为我们众人舍了，生成为是饥饿吗？是赤身裸体危险刀剑吗？不论是高处的，是低处的，现在的事，将来的事，都不能将我一生的隔绝。难道是患难吗？是困苦吗？是逼迫吗？是饥饿吗？是赤身裸体危险刀剑吗？无论是高处的，是低处的，现在的事，将来的事，都不能将我与神的爱隔绝，都不能将。是患难吗？是困苦吗？是逼迫吗？是饥饿吗？是赤身裸体危险刀剑吗？不论是高处的，是低处的，现在的事，将来的事，都不能将我与神的爱隔绝。
好不好？我们来回应神的大爱。
话在我心，使我脚步不偏离，领我走这人生的路。你的爱在我心，你必与我同行，牵我的手
Spend some time in prayer.
教会今天我们要花一点时间来祷告。
And we know we've always been praying through the whole COVID-19 situation.
我们一直以来都是为着这个疫情，积极祷告。
This weekend the Lord placed upon me to lead us in a prayer over Thailand.
这个周末呢，神带领了我要与大家一起来祷告，我们要祝福泰国。
The situation there is pretty bad.
那边的那个疫情情况特别严峻。
I think they just reported, I think on.Just this past Friday, 22 over 1,000 new cases.
这个两天前星期五呢，他们有差不多22,000宗新确诊。
In total, they've actually got 800 over 1,000 cases.
总共加起来呢，其实这个国家有差不多超过800,000的人已经确诊了。
And the issue that they're facing really is that their healthcare systems are being overwhelmed.
他们主要的关键的问题就在于他们整个医疗系统呢，现在已经无法应付了。
So I was saying that even in the capital Bangkok, they've been having to try and send people out to the different provinces to get treatment.
现在甚至在他们的首都就是曼谷呢，他们都已经不够人手了，甚至将一些确诊的病人呢患者带去其他的泰国的其他地方去求医。
We've also been hearing with the different churches we work with in Thailand that the situation there is really problematic.
我们也从在泰国的一起在合作的教会们的那边的人也收到很多信息，就是那个情况真的是挺糟糕的。
And so at the rest of our services, I led us as a church to pray for Thailand. We're going to do the same thing for this service.
所以呢，正如于我们其他的这个周末的其他的聚会，我们为着泰国祷告，现在我们也要这样做。
So there are a few things we need to be praying for.
所以我们需要为几个事项祷告。
Firstly, let's pray for the government and the leaders of all the relevant agencies and so on.
首先我们为着泰国的所有的不同的政府机构，还有不同的 领袖们祷告。
Because they have to come up with different policies and give direction during this time.
因为他们必须做出对应的一些政策还有措施来应付这个问题。
Let's ask for God's anointing of wisdom to be upon them.
求主这个智慧的恩膏会临在所有的国家领袖。
Secondly, we want to pray for the healthcare system.
第二呢，我要为着泰国的那个医疗系统跟制度来祷告。
The different hospitals and of course the staff themselves.
不断是公家或者是私家的医院，还有所有的医护人员。
They need wisdom. They need God's strength to sustain them.
他们需要神的力量，他们也需要智慧来应付。
Lastly, we're going to be praying for the people who have COVID.
最后呢，我们要为这确诊的患者们祷告。
Let's pray that they're able to receive the treatment they need to receive.
让我们祷告他们能够接受到这个适当的治疗。
Let's ask God for healing to be upon them.
求主赐医治。
And actually, one more thing, let's be praying for the church in Thailand as well.
还有呢，多一件事情就是我们要为这泰国的教会祷告。
Let's pray that they'll rise up.
祷告他们会兴起来。
Let's ask that God will use them to bring hope to those around them.
求主使用他们将盼望带给所有的人。
Let's also ask God for His wisdom and His strength to be upon the church.
我们也求主的智慧，还有会给所有的教会都能够加添到力量。
So these are the four things we're going to pray for.
所以为这四件事项祷告。
The leaders of the nation.
国家的领袖。
The healthcare system and professionals.
医疗这个系统，还有所有的医护人员。
Those who are unwell.
确诊的患者们
and finally the church.
还有最后为泰国的众教
会 So I'm going to count to three.
所以要数到三了
And I count three, we just declare hallelujah three times.
数到三的时候呢，我们要喊大喊三声 hallelujah.
And then let's begin to pray.
然后就开始迫切的祷告
You can pray in tongues, you can pray in Mandarin.
你可以用方言，可以用华语来祷告
But let's pray for these four areas.
那时候我们就开始祷告吧
Okay, ready? One,
一,
two, and three. Hallelujah. Let's pray right now.
开始祷告 主，我们感谢你，因为你好爱泰国。
And Lord, we read with broken hearts as we hear about the situation there.
当我们知道他们那边的情况有多糟糕，我们都心碎了。
And so we cry for your presence to be.
所以求主的同在临在泰国。
Lord, we commit their leaders to your hands.
主啊，我们将他们的领袖交托在你手中。
Give them wisdom and foresight.
求你赐给他们这个远见，还有这个智慧。
To know how to face and handle the situation.
好，让他们知道怎么如何去应付接下来的情况。
We pray for all the healthcare workers.
我们为着所有的医护人员祷告。
May you strengthen them.
求主加添力量给他们
May you sustain them.
求你让他们可以持续的继续工
作 May you watch over them.
也求主看顾他们
We pray over the sick, Lord.
我们为这患者们祷告
We ask that they will have access to the treatments they need.
求主让他们得到他们所需要的治疗
We ask that you strengthen their bodies, their being, so that they can resist the virus.
求主让他们更他们整个免疫系统强壮起来
And we cry out for their healing, O Lord.
我们也呼求主啊，求你医治
And Lord, we pray for the churches in Thailand.
主啊，我们也为这泰 泰国众教会祷告。
During this time, may you use them to bring your hope to those around.
在这期间，求你使用他们做盐做光，将盼望带给所有的人。
May they themselves have a fresh encounter of your hope.
愿他们能够也亲身的经历到主你所赐的盼望。
I ask your wisdom to be upon the pastors of the land.
求主赐给众教会的牧者们你的智慧。
To learn to know how to shepherd their people during this time.
好让他们学习到如何更好的去牧养他们的会众。
And more than that, I ask that they will have a heart of a shepherd for the entire nation.
更多的求主赐给他们有牧者的心，要牧养整个教会整个国家。
We commit Thailand to your hands.
所以主啊，我们将泰国恭敬的交在你手中。
We ask for open doors.
求主打开所有的门。
We ask for breakthroughs.
求主赐突破。
And may you lead this country, Lord.
求主你来带领这国家。
In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray.
奉耶稣基督的大名祷告。
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Praise you, Lord. Praise
you, Lord. 赞美主，Hallelujah.
Lord Church, thanks for taking this time to pray for Thailand.
各位弟兄姊妹，感谢你们陪同我们一起来祷告，祝福泰国。
There are many different situations going on around us.
我们知道，在我们身边还有身边的不同的国家都经历着不同的状况。
And at least in this week ahead, can we just remember to pray for Thailand?
接下来这一周，当你做做灵修祷告的时间，请纪念泰国。
Well, if you're not seated yet, please be seated.
请各位现在如果你站立着的可以坐下来了。
And as we're in this atmosphere of worship,
我们现在还在这个敬拜的这个气氛里面。
And we're going to worship the Lord through the giving of our tithes and our offering.
我们要透过我们的奉献还有任献来敬拜我们的主。
And so I'll pass over the time to Paul who will collect the offering.
好，让我来为大家来分享一下我们的线上这个收奉献的这个过程是什么样子的。各位弟兄姊妹，如果你现在看到你的屏幕呢，你将会看见屏幕上有两个不同的二维码，也就是 QR 码。左边呢红色的二维码呢就是我们来做我们立场十一奉献的二维码，你可以使用你所属银行的那个应用程序来进行扫码。然后呢，在你右边你看到这个蓝色的二维码呢，就是在你十一奉献立场奉献以上，你觉得你有感动，你要祝福万国的，你可以扫一扫这个蓝色的二维码来做你的信心任献。好，记得两个二维码都需要使用你所属的银行这个应用程序。然后呢，如果你现在今天你的银行所属银行的应用程序有技术上的问题的话呢，请不要担心，你在屏幕上还是可以看到一个网络的链接，你可以去到这个网络的链接来进行你的奉献。好，让我来为大家做一个祝福的祷告。亲爱的主啊，我们感谢你，我们要特别的今天在做这个奉献的过程当中，求主怜悯我们，也听到我们刚才所做的祷告。主啊，我们要祝福泰国，而我们也祷告当我们做出这个奉献的时候，主啊，你会使用这个奉献来扩张神的国度，不单是在新加坡，而且也是扩张神的国度在万国。所以我们感谢你，主。我们知道，当我们做奉献的时候，主，你是你是悦纳的，你是喜乐的。然后，当我们做这奉献的时候，主啊，我们也是要甘心乐意。所以，求主祝福我们，愿我们的身心灵都蒙福。感谢主，我们这样祷告，奉耶稣得胜的名求，阿门。好，今天有其他的两项报告，我先分享第一个报告，然后第二个报告比较重要，我会让主任牧师来分享。好，现在大家先让我来给大家做一做这个简短的。哦，好，我们呢就是会有这个，接下来我们会有一个很特别的一个课程，就是叫做生活对话日语课程。这个就是日语的课程，我们将从9月7号到11月16号透过 Zoom 的这个网上的平台呢，以英语来进行生活对话日语的课程的第二部分，之前已经主办过第一个部分了。你无需参加过第一个部分才能够报读第二个部分的，所以呢鼓励大家其实也可以用日语来跟你认识的日本人在新加坡也可以透过那个来交朋友，除此之外也可以传福音。然后呢，在十堂课开始之前呢，会有一堂对课程的第一部分的一个简介介绍。好，这个课程的费用呢是50块钱，包括课本。而我们鼓励大家，如果你真的有兴趣的话，请在 8月24号之前上网到我们教会的、屏幕上的这个网络链接 fcbc.org.hg/japanesecourse 来报名、所以继续、要知道更多详情呢，可以上到我们的官网来知道更多的详情。好，我现在将第二个报告的时间交给主任牧师。
Thanks, Paul. The next announcement is on our resumption of services.
下一个报告呢，就是关于我们要第三次，我们又要恢复我们的实体聚会了。感谢主。
I think we all know we've been hearing the news about the easing of certain regulations.
我们大家都听说了，从官方也知道了，我们的很多措施要开始放宽了。
And I thought I'd give us an update on what our services will be looking like.
我也要跟大家分享一下我们的关于这个恢复我们聚会的这个动向。
Well, from next weekend onwards, we'll be resuming our on-site services here at TC.For our English and Chinese services.
从下个周末开始，就是8月21号到8月22号的那个周末，我们将在触爱中心，也就是在这里马林百列，恢复我们的实体聚会。
Our English on-site service will be Saturday night 7:30 p.m. or the Chinese on-site will be our usual Chinese service at 11:30 a.m. on Sunday.
我们的英语聚会呢是在星期六晚上七点半。恢复实体聚会，然后华语的实体聚会呢将会在星期日的照常的11:30。
We're going to put the roster up on the screen right now.
我们也会把这个轮替表现在放在屏幕上。
So the respective teams are assigned for these two weekends.
所以这些团队牧师的团队呢，你们都可以关注一下。
So next weekend, we'll look forward to having those of you from Pastor Daniel and Patsy Gunn's team.
然后呢，我们下个星期呢的中文聚会呢，就是欢迎严中明牧师师母的团队来参加我们的实体聚会。
And the weekend after that will be those of you from Pastor Kim Ming, Hui Ting, as well as Pastor Patrick and Hillary's.
然后后个周末，也就是八月的最后一个周末呢，就是欢迎钟金明牧师，还有
Patrick
Pang 牧师，我不懂他中文名了。好，你们大概知道你们是谁，欢迎你们回来我们的实体聚会。
Do take note that we're only resuming English and Chinese for now. Hokkien Youth and GKids services will still be online for now.
现时呢，我们只会恢复英语还有华语的实体聚会。我们的福建聚会，还有我们的青少年聚会，还有居带儿童的，我们会晚一点再做打算。
Our deaf and mute services will be online as well.
我们的特殊的聋哑这个聚会呢，也暂时。仍然以线上的形式来进行。
Now the reason we only give out 2 weekends worth of a roster.
我们为什么现在只跟大家分享就是接下来两个周末的那个轮替表呢
？It's because we're expecting further updates to the regulations at the start of September.
因为我们知道在九月头的时候呢，很可能会有更多的更新关于那个聚集的这个条规。
And there's still quite a lot of details that have to be worked out.
还有很多细节要准备的。
So we'll give you as many updates as we can.
所以我们会就是观察这个状况，然后呢尽快的也跟大家分享。
Now for our services that will be resuming, we will be able to accommodate up to 200 people.
我们的实体聚会呢，我们是可以容许上达200人来参加聚会的。
If you want to attend the on-site service, you must fulfill one of the following criteria.
如果你要参加我们的实体聚会呢，我们是的确有一些条规，你要符合其中一个的。
Firstly, you must be one is fully vaccinated, meaning 2 weeks after your second dose.
首先呢，就是你要完全的已经接种了两次打针的那个疫苗，然后呢，也两个星期后已经恢复了。那是第一个。
Secondly, you must have recovered from COVID-19.
第二呢，就是你确诊过，然后你已经恢复了。
Or the third one is that you must obtain a valid negative pre-event test result.
然后呢，第三呢，就是有一个合格的参加聚会或者活动前的一个测试来确诊来确实你是没有患到这个新冠病毒的。
So you must fulfill one of these three criteria.
所以你必须符合到这三个不同的条规的其中一个。
So meaning some of you are not fully vaccinated yet.
或许你还没有完全的完成了你的接种疫苗。
Or some of you have not been vaccinated at all.
或者你因为有一些原因你完全没有去打到这个针。
You can still be in attendance. You just need to have that valid negative pre-event test result.
你仍然可以来参加我们的实体聚会。只是之前呢，你必须做一个简单的测试来确实你是没有确诊的。
We'll have more information on this up on our website.
我们的教会的官网呢会有更多的详情。
The website's up on the screen right now.
现在在屏幕上可以看到那个官网的链接了。
Of course, do take note that this pre-event testing is not the home test kit.
请大家也要知道，这一个活动前的那一个简单的那个测试，并不是零售店可以买到的那一些的那一个检测仪。
It's a formal test that you have to take at one of the approved test centers.
而是在我们的国家的官方的一些测试中心得到的那个成绩才可以。
All right, so for the parents, children age 12 years and below, you can attend our on-site service together with you.
爸爸妈妈们，如果你们的孩子是12岁以下的呢，孩子们是可以来参加这个实体聚会的。
They are ineligible for vaccination and they are also exempted from pre-event testing.
他们暂时现在是不可以去接种疫苗的，而且呢，活动前的那个测试呢，他们也是不需要的。
So you're able to bring them along, but we just ask that you exercise discretion in the area.
所以呢，你是可以带他们进入我们的实体聚会，可是也要求家长们的配合，感谢你们。就是如果他们不舒服啊，他们就应该待在家里休息。
So for those attending, tickets will be open as usual Wednesday night 9 p.m.
所以打个比方说，下星期是严中明牧师的团队。来临的星期三晚上呢，那个票呢就会在网上可以预定了。
And your respective pastors will send you the link. Your pastors and leaders will send you the link on the day itself.
你们的团队牧师或者是领袖会将那个链接发给你们。
All right. So again, do take note. For more information, head to our website on the screen.
是的，所以如果也同样的需要知道更多的详情呢，也是可以到屏幕上的这个网络链接。
We have our service resumption website.
我们有我们恢复实体聚会的网络链接。
So this is all the information you need on coming back to our services.
所以回到我们实体聚会呢，就是这一个屏幕所看到的网络链接。
And the second one will be our website on the COVID-19 measures you need to be aware of.
然后第二个现在屏幕上看到第二个链接呢，就是关于这个冠状病毒，而我们教会的官方的回应还有很多的指示。
And the updates there are concerning cell groups, funerals, and weddings even.
这个屏幕上的网络链接就会告诉我们更多关于小组的进行啊，或者是丧礼或者是婚礼的一些措施。
All right, so that's the important announcement I would like to make.
好，就是因为这个报告是有点困难，所以就由我来跟大家分享更多的详情更好。
And I will give more updates through your respective leaders over time.
我会透过你们的团队牧师还有领袖们呢晚一点会跟你们分享更多的这些动向跟消息。
So with that, let's jump into the Word of God for this weekend.
好了，所以呢，我们就要进入我们这个周末的这个信息话题。
Now this week is actually a special week for us as a church.
这个周末其实是我们教会一个非常特别的一个周末。
This coming week itself actually will mark our 35th anniversary as a church.
来临的这星期就是我们教会坚信经信教会的35周年了。
And next weekend onwards, I'm going to lead us into a new series of messages.
然后下个周末开始呢，我会带领大家来进入一个新的信息系列主题。
It's going to be a series of messages about our church specifically.
就是这一个系列的这个主题呢，信息就是关于我们教会的。
And we're going to explore together about who we are as a church, what our beliefs are, and why we even exist.
我会跟大家分享我们到底是谁，我们的这个信仰是什么呢？还有为什么我们会存在着。
And we believe it's important to come back to talk about our vision, our values, and so on as we go into the new season ahead.
当我们进入来临的新季节，我觉得重新分享我们的意向、我们的价值观是非常重要的。
But before we get there,
可是在我们分享这些之前呢
？This weekend, I thought I'd like to bring us a fundamental teaching about what the church is all about.
这个周末呢，我想分享关于教会的一个非常基本的一个教导。
And every time we talk about the church,
每次我提到教会
coming to a church service or whether it's on-site or online,
进入一个教会的聚会，又或者在线上参加聚会
I'm always reminded of a very simple verse.
我通常都会被提醒到一个非常简单的一段经文
Matthew chapter 18 verse 20.
马太福音第十八章第二十节，因为哪里有两三个人奉我的名聚会，我就在哪里与他们同在。
I think this short verse here is a straightforward expression of what church is all about.
我觉得这一段非常简短的经文呢，就让我们看见其实教会是什么了。
Church and going to a church service is not just about a program. It is not just about a place.
教会还有去参加聚会呢，不单单只是一个活动节目，也不单单只是一个会所场所。
It's about being the people of God.
更重要的是神的子民。
About the people of God coming together.
神的子民聚集在一起。
In His name.
奉他的名。
Being in His presence.
在他的同在里，一同在他同在里。
You know, this is important for us to remember as we go through the pandemic.
当我们经历这个疫情呢，我觉得这是一个更重要的一个提醒了。
During this time, how we experience church, how we engage with the church has changed drastically.
在这段期间，我们经历教会的过程，我们一起做教会的过程，已经变得很不一样了。
But the fundamentals of what church is has not changed at all.
可是到底教会是什么？那个根基完全是没有改变到的。
A couple of years ago, I wrote down three things about what church is all about.
一两年前呢，我就写下了三句话。这三句话对我来说就是教会。
I'll ask Paul to read them.
好，第一句就是，教会不只是去到一个地点，而是成为群体的一员。这是第一句。第二句，教会不只是履行宗教责任，而是与基督建立关系。第三。教会不只是让我感到满足，而是要改变我的生命。
You know, as I look at these three things, I think they're so relevant in this time that we're in.
当我看到这，重新看一看这三段话，我就觉得特别符合现在我们这个状况。
See, if a church is only about a place,
如果教会只是一个场所
，then for the last 1.5 years or so, our church hasn't existed.
那这一年半来呢，这我们教会基本上也不存在的。
If church is just about a religious duty.
如果教会只是关于履行一个宗教责任的话
Then the last 1.5 years we might not have, well, we might not qualify to be Christians.
那这一年半来我们基本上就是成为了不合格的基督徒了。
If church is all about just feeling content.
如果教会的重要性只是关乎到我的自我满足的话
Then the last 1.5 years we haven't been to church.
这一年半来我们就没去过教会了。
But those things are not true.
可是这些都不是真实的。
Because in the last 1.5 years, even though our experience of church has changed,
因为在这一年半来，就算我们对于教会的那个经历改变了
，we may not have all been able to set foot in this place.
或许我们都没有办法一起的来踏入这个场所
，but we are still part of a people.
可是我们仍然是群体的一员。
We may not be able to attend an on-site service.
我们或许没有机会参加实体聚会。
But we're still able to have relationship with one another and be in a relationship with God.
我们仍然可以跟彼此有一段关系，然后也继续的跟基督建立关系。
We may not have felt all that content with all the situations going around us.
或许我们看着所有的疫情的发生，我们觉得特别不满足。
But yet through all this, God is able to change us.
可是透过这一切，神仍然可以改变我们。
So this really frames my message for us this weekend.
所以这就的确了给我。这个周末的信息造了一个框架。
And the message I have is simply called this.
而我这个周末的主题就是叫做
The Church.
教会。
I want to talk to us about the church.
我要跟大家讨论关于我们的教会。
Now when we look into scripture,
当我们看一看去钻研一下经文的时候
The word church is mentioned several times.
在这个教会这个字呢有好几次在圣经里面出现过。
And it's particularly mentioned in the New Testament, so we often have a Greek word for the word church.
尤其是在新约，然后在新约呢，我们通常都会有一个希腊文来描述教会。
We may have heard this word before.
你可能在也听过这个希腊文的字。
The word for church in Greek is the Greek word ecclesia.
教会希腊文叫做 ecclesia.
And what it means is that it's a called out assembly, congregation, or people.
它的意思就是什么呢？是被呼召的集会、会众或民众。
So this is.I want us to keep in mind this definition.
我要大家记得这个定义 ，Ecclesia.
And with that, I want to jump into my main sharing for today.
那我就要进入我们主要的分享了。
What is church all about?
到底什么是教会
？Well, there are three things I want to share with us.
我要跟大家分享三个要点。
Number one.
第一
，Church is about community.
教会其实是属神的群体。
A church is a godly community, and we cannot escape from this.
教会是一个属神的群体，而我们不能脱离这个定义。
Without a community, without people, then this place is just any other building.
没有属神的群体，没有属神的子民，这个场所就只是一个地点而已。
Sure, in the last 1.5 years, our engagement in church is very different.
是的，这一年半来，我们在教会如何跟大家有互动是变得很不一样了。
But yet, in the last 1.5 years, we still are.In a community.
然而，在这一年半来，我们仍然是一个属神的群体，在群体里面。
I remember a while ago I was leading a devotional.
我记得呢，有一段时间我在带领我的同工来做一个灵修。
And I asked a group of them. I said, you know, why do you go to church?
我就问了他们这个问题，我就问他们为什么你去教会。
And I let them discuss, and then later we heard all the answers.
然后他们就分成小组去讨论，回来之后呢，就听到很多的解答。
Now there were many different answers.
当时他们的分享有很多不同的。
And a lot of the answers are all good.
他们的答案都是很好的。
But one of the most consistent answers I heard was this.
可是一个最普遍听到的答案就是这个了。
We go to church because of friends, family, relationships, cell group, because of the people.
我们去教会是因为有朋友、有家人、有关系、有小组、有人呐。
Essentially, it's about a community.
最终就是关乎到人，就是那个群体里面的人了。
You see, if we go back and look at Matthew 18:20,
如果我们回去到刚才那个短短的经文，就是马太福音第十八章第二十节说，说什么呢？就是因为那里有两三个人奉我的名聚会，我就在哪里与他们同在。
See, what it says right there is that it doesn't say where someone gathers.
它并不是说当有一个人聚在一个地方。
No, scripture here jumps into talking about community.
这个经文呢就直接说到一个群体了。
These two or three, I mean, it's not a formula.
这个两三个人并不是一个方程式。
The principle here is that there's an important aspect of community.
就是它的一个很重要的关键的部分，就是它有一个群体在一起的一个重要性。
If you go back and look at the Greek word for church,
如果我们回到刚才，我们知道教会的它的那个原本希腊文的意思。
A called out assembly, congregation, or people.
一个被呼召的集会、会众或者民众。
See, there's such a big focus on community.
所以他们在这个关注里面，这个群体呀是特别重要的。
In fact, God created us to be in community.
甚至其实上帝他创造了我们，就是要我们在群体里面的。
Look at Genesis chapter 2 verse 18.
让我们来看一看《创世纪》第二章第十八节告诉我们，耶和华上帝说：“那人独自一人不好，我要为他造一个相配的帮手。”
Now.Of course, this verse applies to God creating Eve for Adam.
当然，这段经文是当时是说到上帝为亚当创造了夏娃。
But yet the principle applies.
可是那个原则是仍然可以应用的。
We are reminded that we're not created to be alone. We're not meant to live in isolation.
神提醒了我们，我们独自一人不好，我们不应该被孤立。
See, Jesus said this in John chapter 17.
耶稣在约翰福音第十七章二十节到二十一节告诉我们，我不单为这些人祈求，也为那些因他们的话而信我的人祈求，使他们都合而为一，正如父你在我里面，我在你里面一样，并且使他们也在我们里面，好让世人相信是你差我来的。
Interesting passage here.
这段话特别的有意思。
Jesus wants us to be one.
耶稣希望我们合而为一。
He didn't say he wants us to be individuals.
他并不希望我们都是独立的个体。
Or rather, maybe a better way to say, he didn't want us to be isolated.
更说的更确切的，他不希望我们会被孤立分开来。
He wants us to be many people, but yet one in the same spirit, one in unity.
他希望我们是众多子民，可是仍然我们是合而为一，同一条心的。
You see this emphasis on a community.
你看到这里的关注，就是说到我们要在群体里面了。
And what makes it so interesting is that he compares us to him and the heavenly Father.
这里很特别，就是他对于我们跟他与天父的关系做了一个比较。
Why is this so interesting?
为什么那么有意思呢？
Because God himself exists in community.
因为神他也是在群体里面的。
He exists as the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
他的彰显就是在于父、子和圣灵。
When we look at Genesis, the creation of humanity.
当我们看到在创世纪神在创造人的时候。
What did God say?
神说什么呢？
Let us create man in our image.
他就说了，让我们创造人跟的形象跟我是一样的。
He said, "Let us."
让我们
create man in our image.
创造人以我们的形象。
Why the plural? Why this word?
为什么会说我们呢？
Because God exists in community.
因为神也是在群体里面。
And when Jesus prays this prayer, he said, "Just like we exist in community, God." May others also do the same.
因为这里写，正如他们都合而为一，父你在我里面，我在你里面。
See, community is so fundamentally important in the church.
所以我要跟你说，在教会里面有一个群体合而为一是最重要的。
You know, when we talk about community, we often think about, you know, it's a group of people who share common interests.
啊，当我们说到在一个群体里面呢，啊，我们都会说到这群人有一个合一，有一个共同的一个志向。
Common maybe characteristics,
啊，有一个共同的一些性格啊，或者是他们有共同的工作之类的。
But I've always shared this very simple thing about community.
可是我通常都会很简单的给这群体这个字做一个定义。
Community basically is a commitment to unity.
群体就是什么呢？群策群力，体现合一。
I think that's a very simple explanation.
这对我来说是一个非常简单的一个定义。
Is that if we want to be a community, we must be committed to be united.
如果我们要成为一个群体的话，我们就要群策群力，体现合一。
That's why Jesus prayed for us to be one.
所以呢，耶稣为我们做的祷告就是我们可以合而为一了。
Now you see, just by coming together, just by gathering together, doesn't make us a community.
可是我想说的是，当我们相聚的时候，并不代表我们是合而为一的。
You can be gathered with a few hundred other people on an MRT. It doesn't mean you are a community.
或许你在地铁上跟百多个人全部站在一起的，可是不代表你是群体。
You have to be part of a people where you guys are all committed to the unity.
你们必须是属于一群人，而你们呢，全部是群策群力，体现合一的。
Now, why am I raising?
为什么我要提这一点呢？
Well, maybe I guess it's not really a new issue that surfaced in Christianity.
在基督教里面，这并不是一个新的一个现象。
It's existed long ago.
早就有了。
And it will continue to exist in the future.
而群体这个问题呢，以后也会相继会有的。
And sometimes this issue crops up, particularly as technology advances.
而当我们发现到这个科技的发展呢，然后我们就发现到这个群体的重要性或者问题会浮现。
What is this issue I'm talking about?
我想说的这个是什么事呢？
Is that there are Christians who do not see that being in a community is important.
因为的确有一些人觉得在群体里面并不重要。
Years ago, a study was done about churches in the United States.
好几年前呢，在美国做了一个研究。
And it was discovered that attendance in churches were going down.
然后就发现到了，其实去教会参加聚会的人的人数已经慢慢的下降了。
And there are many reasons for that, of course.
他们当然也可以发现到有很多不同的原因。
But one of the reasons is this.
可是其中一个原因是什么呢？
Is that there are Christians who feel that they can be a Christian but don't need to be part of a church?
因为开始有这样的一个想法，就是这些人觉得我可以是一名基督徒，可是我不需要去教会。
So in a survey they say I'm a Christian.
所以呢，在这个调查里面呢，他就说我是基督徒。
But when they ask, they say, "Oh, but I don't belong to a church. I'm not part of a church community."
可是他们就会回答说，我是基督徒，可是呢，我不是任何教会的，我也不是任何教会群体的。
And all of them say, you know what? We don't need to go to church.
然后他们甚至还说，你知道吗？其实我觉得我们不需要去教会。
You know, just because I go to church doesn't make me a Christian.
去教会不代表我是基督徒。
Well, that's true.
那是真的。
There are many people who can come to church but yet not be part of, but not actually be a Christian.
很多人来参加聚会了，可是未必是信徒的。
But we need to understand this truth.
可是我们必须理解这个真理。
We cannot profess to be a Christian but yet not be connected to God's community.
我们不能说声称自己是基督徒，可是然而我们不参与神的群体。
Those are not my words.
这些不是我的话，不是我讲的话。
I am not saying this.
并不是我说的。
The Bible says this.
圣经里面说的。
God's word teaches us this.
神的话语教导我们如此的。
God said it's not good for us to be alone.
圣经教导我们，我们独自一人不好。
In the book of John, Jesus prayed that we will be one.
而刚才在约翰福音，耶稣祷告我们可以合而为一。
In the book of Hebrews, it says this in chapter 10.
希伯来书第十章也告诉了我们，我们要想办法彼此相顾，激发爱心，勉励行善，不要停止聚会，像那些停止惯了的人，要互相鼓励，特别是你们知道主再来的日子近了。
See, there's so many times that the Bible emphasizes on being in a community.
圣经里面有很多次都特别的关注于我们要聚集，我们要相聚的意思。
And well, one expression of a community is, well,being part of the church.
而其中一个表达的方式就是我们要在教会成为教会的一部分。
You know, a lot of people say, you know, I don't need the church.
很多人会说，我不需要教会。
I can worship God myself, right?
我可以自己敬拜主啊。
I can pray myself, right?
我可以自己在家里自己祷告啊。
I can read the Bible by myself.
我可以自己可以读圣经啊。
I can even watch sermons by myself.
我可以甚至自己看着教会的聚会啊。
Now I can download so many sermons online and everything.
现在我在线上还可以下载很多很多不一样的牧师讲的信息。
Now, there's nothing wrong with all of that.
做这些事都是好的，没错的。
Okay, but if that's all you do.
可是如果你仅仅只做这样子事情的话
It's still incomplete.
还是不完整的
You see, you can worship God by yourself.
是的你是可以独自一人敬拜主的
But if that's all you do,
可是如果你仅仅只这样做的话
You will never understand what it means to worship in unity.
你就不会理解到合一的敬拜是什么样子的了
You can pray to God by yourself.
你可以独自一个人对着上帝祷告
But if that's all you do, then you'll never know what it means to pray together in unity.
你就不会理解到合一的祷告是什么样子还有什么样的力量
You can listen, to a sermon by yourself.
你或许可以独自一人参加聚会，听牧师讲道。
But if that's all you do, then you will never learn what it means to listen to God's word together.
可是如果你仅仅这样做的话，你是永远不会学习到如何合一的在群体里面一起来领受神的话语。
And I want to say this to us right now.
而我现在想跟大家一起说。
You know, we talk about.Our individual expression of our faith.
你说到我们每个人都有一个特别独特的一个表达敬拜的方式。
And there's also a community expression of our faith.
我们也是有一个群体的表达我们信仰的一个方式。
These two things is never an either or situation.
这两者并不是选一或者二选一的一个选项。
It is both and.
是两者兼施的。
That's why I say if all we do is express our faith individually.
所以如果我说我只需要单独的自己做敬拜，自己听到自己祷告。
This is why I say it is incomplete.
所以我就说这个是不完整的了。
I didn't say it's incorrect.
我并不是说这个是不对的。
It is incomplete.
只是不完整。
See, Jesus says this also in the book of John.
耶稣在约翰福音也说过这段话，第十三章第三十四节到第三十五节。我赐给你们一条新命令，你们要彼此相爱。我怎样爱你们，你们也要怎样彼此相爱。你们如果彼此相爱，世人就会认出你们是我的门徒。
Right here, look at this verse.
在这里看看这段经文哈。
Jesus teaches us here that there is you can prove that you are his disciples.
他教导我们，耶稣教导我们，我们是能够证明我们是他的门徒。
And you do so by loving each other in the church.
你怎么样证明呢？就是要在教会里面彼此相爱。
So basically, it means this, you know.
所以他的意思就是什么呢
？You see, we cannot.Express love if we're not in a community.
如果我们不在一个群体里面，我们是很难表达爱的。
And if you cannot demonstrate this love for a community,
如果你无法为了你的群体而表现爱的话
，you cannot say that you are actually Jesus' disciple.
你就不能说其实你是耶稣的门徒了。
It's not what these are not my words.
这些不是我说的。
This is what Jesus himself said.
是耶稣自己说的。
So today we must realize that we have to be in part of a community.
所以今天我们就要学习到，我们必须在群体里面特别重要。
Yes, that we will always have our personal expression of our faith, our personal connection to God.
是的，我们跟神联系上了，其实是一个很独特，就是你自己能有的、能做的事情，你自己敬拜主。
But there's also a communal expression of that.
可是我们也有一个群体性的一个表达方式对于神。
So that's the first thing I want to share about.
所以我想分享的第一个要点。
What is a church?
教会是什么呢？
Firstly,
什么是教会？
It's a community.
首先，它是一个属神的群体。
A godly community.
一个属神的一个群体。
Number two.
第二
，Church is also about communion.
教会也是关乎到一种交流。很亲密的一个交流
communion in the sense of having a relationship with God
这种交流呢就是与神有一个建立的一个关系
see this is you know this is a good follow up from this whole idea of community
这个呢就相继着刚才我们所说的群体的重要性
now what is this communion all about
这个交流这个亲密的交流是什么呢
this is what is defined as
这是它的定义就在这里了他说交流是分享或交换亲密的思绪或感受的一个思绪或者感受尤其是在心理或属灵的层面上
So you see, when I say that church is about communion
就是说刚才我说到教会是关于教会就是一个亲密的交流的话
Is that church is the community where we receive from God, where we connect with God.
就是说，其实教会就是一个地方，好让我们可以跟神联系上，我们可以跟神一起沟通。
Again, look at Matthew chapter 18, verse 20.
同样呢，我们看回刚才那一段哈，这里说，因为哪里有两三个人奉我的名聚会，我就在哪里与他们同在。
So it starts off talking about community where two or more are gathered.
所以这段经文开头就是说到群体了，因为两三个人奉我的名聚会。
And the end of it reminds us that we are there for connection, for communion with God.
他就然后这下半段就告诉了我们，我们其实聚会的目的就是与神同在，与神交流。
And there's an important aspect of connecting with God as a community.
而我们以一个群体的形式与神交流是特别的重要的。
See, this is something important we must understand.
我们必须理解这个要点。
Again, just now we talked about our individual expression versus our communal expression.
同样的，刚才我们说到了我们独立表达，还有以群体对神的一个信心表达。
Can we connect with God individually?
我们是否可以单独的与神有交流呢？
Of course we can.
当然可以啦。
But yet we must also have this communal connection with God.
可是我们仍然需要有一个群体性的交流，群体性的一个亲密互动与神。
And when it comes to the church,
所以当我们说到教会的时候，
at a church service,
在教会的聚会，
this is where we come together as a people to connect with God.
我们就是以神的子民的身份一起聚集，与神有交流。
When we worship together,
当我们一同敬拜的时候，
it is all of us crying out to God.
我们是集体一起呼喊呼求主啊。
We express our deep desire to encounter and experience God.
我们的内心深处合而为一的一起表达与神的渴望。
It's just like this part of scripture in Psalm 84.
就有如经文在诗篇八十四章第一节到第二节告诉我们，万军之耶和华啊，你的居所多么美好，我深愿进入耶和华的这个园宇，我的身心向永活的上帝欢呼。
See, worship is when we cry out to God like that.
敬拜的时候就是我们一起向神这样子的呼求。
And when we worship as a community, it's our whole community crying out to God.
当我们集体向神呼求的，我们就每个人都全心全人一起的向神表达。
Then, during our church service, so we also will receive from the sermon, from the word of God.
而当我们在群体的时候呢，我们会领受到神透过牧师所赐下的话语。
You know, when a preacher preaches,
你知道讲道员在讲道的时候，
we often call it bringing the word of God.
我们都会说我们带来神的话语。
Because when someone preaches, you are receiving God's word for you and for the whole church.
因为当这个讲道员带着神的话语给你们的时候，你领受的话语不单给自己，也是给一群人。
This is what we as preachers are entrusted with.
所以我们讲道员的这个身负的重任就是如此。
This is written in 2 Timothy chapter 4.
这也在提摩太后书第四章告诉我们的。我们来看一看第一节跟第二节。在上帝和审判活人死人的基督耶稣面前，我凭基督的显现和他的国郑重嘱咐你，无论时机好坏，都要坚持传道，以百般的忍耐和教导督责人、警戒人、勉励人。
You see, the charge that God gives preachers is to bring God's word to the people.
神郑重的嘱咐给那些讲道员呢，就是要把神的话语给传出去。
See, what I'm teaching us here right now is this.
我现在在教导大家什么呢？
That I say church is about this communion with God.
我们说到教会呢，其实就是与神有亲密的交流。
You see, and when we gather as the church,
而当我们当我们聚集在一起成为教会的时候，
whether on site or online,
无论是实体或者是在线上，
we are connecting to God as a people.
我们都是一群子民同心合一的与神交流。
We cry out to God.
我们呼求神。
And we also receive from His word.
我们也从他的话语里面领受。
And this takes place at the church level.
而这是在一个教会的层面上一起来领受的。
And with that, I want to kind of address three misconceptions that we see in the church.
而我要今天呢，我要纠正我们教会有时候会有一些错误的概念，总共有三个。
I don't mean our church specifically, but I mean churches all around the world.
我并不是说只是我们教会有这个错误概念，我说众教会很多教会都不小心都会有这个错误的概念。
The first misconception is this.
第一个错误的概念是什么呢？
I don't need to be in church to encounter God.
我不需要在教会里才能够经历神。
It is true.
是真的。
You can encounter God personally and individually.
你可以各户体的独自经历到神的。
Moses encountered the presence of God in the burning bush in the middle of the desert by himself.
啊，摩西在沙漠里面，也经历了神，在荆棘火焰那边经历到神。
But as a church, we encounter God together.
可是当我们合而为一成教会的时候，我们是可以一同来经历神的。
Remember, like I said just now, there's a difference between by yourself and together.
记得刚才我说过吗？刚才我们有一个单独的表达，我们也是与神可以有一个群体性的一个表达。
See, we don't need to be in a church to encounter God.
我们需要经历神，我们不需要是在群体教会里面的。
But yet, it's only in a church community that you encounter God in a new way.
可是只有在一个群体，在一个教会里面一起来经历神，才会有一个更新很不一样的一个体验。
See, remember, the word of God says, where two or more are gathered in my name, I am there with them.
记得吗？刚才经文教导我们，当两三个人聚集的聚会的时候呢，他就必与我们同在。
So this premium is put on us gathering together as a people, as a community, as a church to encounter God.
所以这段经文就教导了我们，当我们以一个群体来聚会，神与我们同在是特别更加的珍贵啦。
Now the second misconception is this.
啊，我们第二个这个错误的观念是什么呢？
Worship.It's not my responsibility.
敬拜不是我的责任。
You know, when we come to the church, and then you know the worship team will lead us in a time of worship.
你知道吗？我们来到实体的聚会，然后就看到台上有带领敬拜的团队来带领我们敬拜。
Sometimes we as the church can say that, oh, that's not my responsibility. That's the worship team's responsibility.
有时我们身为教会，我们会觉得敬拜不是我的责任，是台上那几个人的责任。
Now, I'm not saying that the worship team has no responsibility.
好，我现在要重申哈，这群人是有责任的。
What I'm saying is that we all have a part to play. We all have responsibility in this area.
可是我想说的是，我们每一个人在敬拜的时候都有一份责任的。
Why am I saying this?
为什么我这么说呢？
Because I and many pastors around have commonly heard statements like that.
因为我还有众多牧者都经常听到很多人这样子说。
Why the worship team today not very good?
哎呀，今天的敬拜团队不是很好。
The worship team not on form.
啊，今天他们的那个表现好像差了一点。
And that's why I cannot worship God.
所以我没有办法进入敬拜。
I didn't feel like God was moving during the time of
worship. 因此呢，我感受到敬拜的过程中，我没有感受到神呐。
The song selection not nice.
今天选的歌不好听
嘞。The sound wasn't good.
今天的音响不好嘞。
You see, we have all these different things.
我们有很多很多不同的投诉。
But I said we must understand that we have a responsibility in this as well.
可是我说，我们必须理解到，我们每一个人都有一个敬拜上的责任。
See, it's not just about throwing it to somebody else to whose responsibility it is.
我们并不可以这样子的责怪，把责任。推给任何其他的人。
But it's about us coming in to say, God, I want to encounter you.
可是我们必须来到敬拜的环节，而说主啊，我要经历到你。
You see, sometimes we hear this, you know, oh, the worship thing wasn't good, and I didn't feel so. That's why I didn't feel the presence of God.
你不能说有些人有时候有些人会说啊，今天敬拜团队不是很好，所以我觉得我感受不到神的同在。
But God's word says this in Jeremiah 29.
可是神的话语告诉我们在耶利米书第二十九章第十三节说，你们寻求我。就必寻见，只要你们全心寻求我。
See, sometimes the issue is not just the worship team.
有时候呢，那个问题不单单在于敬拜团队的。
Sometimes the issue is with us.
有时候那个问题可能在于我们。
That we have not been the worshippers that we ought to be.
我们并没有成为神要我们成为的那个敬拜者。
See, that's why.Being in a church is so important.
所以来到教会就是这么重要了，来到这个群体这么重要。
We learn how to connect and commune with God as a people.
我们就可以成为一群子民，一同的来敬拜神，一同的来与神交流。
Imagine this.
试想一下。
When we come to church,
我们来到教会了。
Instead of just, you know, 10 people on stage feeling like it's their responsibility for worship.
与其看到台上的敬拜团队，然后觉得哎是他们的责任。
What if?All the few hundreds of us or the few thousands of us say worship is my responsibility.
如果我们几百个人或者几千个人同心合一都觉得敬拜是我的责任。
If I'm on the worship team, I say God help me lead worship in a great way.
如果我在台上带敬拜，我就会说神啊，求你使用我好好的带领一个非常棒的敬拜。
If I'm in the pews or I'm watching it online, I say God help me be the worshipper that I need to be.
如果你在家中观看敬拜，又或者在实体聚会在台下观看，你就祷告说主啊，帮助我成为你要我成为的敬拜者。
If we all have that mindset, then we will encounter God together as a community.
如果我们都是同心合一，有同样的理念，我们就可以很特别的经历到神了。
Now the third misconception I want to talk about is this.
我要提论到的第三个错误观念
is when people say the sermon didn't speak to me.
就当人会说神没有借着讲道对我说话嘞。
Now I'm not addressing this because someone said this to me recently.
我并不是在解答这个部分，因为最近有人跟我说我讲的道没有关到他们的事。
If anything, this is something that pastors hear all the time.
众牧者在讲道的时候都经历到，都会收到这样的反馈的。
But what we need to understand about the, when we hear the word of God from the pulpit.
可是当我们听到台上的讲道的时候，我们必须理解这个重要的部分。
This is God's word for us.
这是神赐给我们，而不是我而已啊，我们的一个信息。
And regardless of how we feel about it,
而无论我们的个人感觉是什么样的，
God wants to speak this word to you.
神要对着你们说这句话。
Even if you say, I've heard this message before.
就算你觉得，哎，这个信息我听过啊。
In fact, my dad always says this.
我爸甚至经常说，
If you find yourself hearing a message and again and again and again,
如果你在听讲道，而听到这个讲道信息重复而又重复的话，
Chances are God wants you to hear it again because we still haven't actually learned that lesson.
很可能是上帝要你再听到这段信息，因为上次你没学到。
See, there's an important aspect about coming together as a church.
当我们聚以教会的形式来聚集的时候呢，有一个很重要的部分。
Is that we listen to the word of God that God has for the whole community.
就是我们一同的聆听神的话语，因为他的话语是给一群人的。
That's how we connect and commune with God.
所以我们就这样子可以跟神连接上了，我们跟神有交流了。
You see, it's when we can...Well, we can read the Bible ourselves. We can study the Word of God ourselves.
我们可以自己在灵修时间自己看圣经，自己学习。
And some people say, you know, why do I need a middleman, a pastor? I can just go and do it myself.
然后你甚至会觉得，为什么我需要一个牧师来帮助我？为什么需要一个中间人呢？我直接从神那边领受吧。
Well, because God wants to speak to all of us.
因为我要跟你说，神要跟我们每一个人都说话。
In fact, sometimes when we read the word of God ourselves,
有时我们独自一个人在听神的话语的时候，
it's very easy for us to end up always reading what we want to read.
我们就很容易读到我们自己想要读的东西。
But when you come to church,
可是当你来了聚会的时候，
when the pastor preaches,
当牧师讲道的时候，
it may not be the word you want to hear.
未必是你需要听的那个信息的。
But I want to tell you something.
可是我要告诉你，
it is the word you need to hear.
是你需要聆听到的信息。
Whether you've heard it before,
无论你听过或者没听过，
whether the pastor delivered it well or not well,
无论这位讲道员讲得好或讲得不好，
there's something there that God wants you to learn.
我们当中是有学习到的功课的。
And so we must have the right attitude.
所以我们必须带着持有一个正确的态度来聆听神的话语。
Just like I said during worship,
就正如我所说，在敬拜的时候，
we must say, God help me be the worshipper I need to be.
你一定要说，主啊，求你帮助我成为我应该成为的那个敬拜者。
Same thing during the time of the sermon, God help me be the listener I need to be.
同样的，当牧者在讲道的时候，你必须有这个态度，说主啊，你帮助我成为那个聆听者。
Now there's a great example in scripture.
我们在经文里面看到一个特别好的榜样。
About how we should be listeners of God's word.
教导我们应该如何成为神话语的很好的一个聆听者。
It's found in Acts chapter 17.
就是在使徒行传第十七章第十一节告诉我们，当地的人比帖撒罗尼迦人通情达理，非常乐意接受真理，还天天查考圣经，研究这道是否正确。
Now this is a good example of how we be listeners.
这是一个非常好的榜样，教导我们怎么样成为一个聆听神话语的人。
You see.He talks about this group of the barren Jews.
他就说了，这里是这群人是比帖撒罗尼迦人的一群人。
And we read about how they studied the scriptures for themselves.
我们就读到了他们如何接受真道，然后考察圣经。
And they examined to see if what Paul preached to them was correct and true.
然后他们天天查考圣经，研究这个道是真的还是假的。
But there was and you know I've heard people use this verse before.
我听到有人的确用过这段经文。
And some people misunderstand.
有些人会有一个错误的理念。
Because I've met many people in church.
因为我见过教会很多人
where they always want to check through scriptures.
他们经常会查考那个圣经，检查一下。
Because they feel like it is their role to be a check and balance for the pastor.
因为他们认为他们要查这个经文呢，就是要帮助讲道员的牧师查是不是讲的对还是讲的错。
But there's something interesting there, you know.
可是这里呢还有一个很重要的一部分。
That about the Berean Jews, they were not doing all this to check up on the pastor.
这些比帖撒罗尼当地的人比帖撒罗尼迦人呢，他们其实做的不是来查牧师讲的道准不准。
They're not trying to catch Paul for saying something wrong.
他们并不是要去抓到保罗讲的东西有没有错误。
But rather they were trying to have a better understanding of Scripture.
与其他们其实的态度就是要更深入的去了解到经文教什么。
See, this verse tells us their attitude towards listening.
这段话语呢，经文就教导了我们聆听神的话语的那个态度。
See, they receive the message from Paul.With great eagerness.
这里教导我们，他们非常乐意接受真道。
They were not disgruntled.
他们并不是充满着埋怨。
They were not upset at what Paul was saying.
保罗所教导的话，他们并不是生气着的。
They were eager to receive it.
他们非常乐意的、积极的去接受的。
And when they receive it, they want to further study the word of God to make sure that they understand and they can live that out better.
然后呢，他们就是天天查考圣经，为的就是理解这个真道更加的深入，然后学习活出来。
See, very often, you know what's the issue? You know, when we say that the sermon didn't speak to us,
当我们有时候不小心唠叨了，就说哎呀，今天的信息不是给我的了。
You know what that really means?
你知道这什么意思吗？
Honestly,
说真的，坦白的。
We weren't listening.
我们其实没有聆听，没有用心的聆听。
You remember Jesus always said something,
你要记住啊，耶稣经常会说。
He'll say, "Those with ears, let them hear."
让他那有耳朵的好好的去聆听。
Why does he say that?
他为什么这么说呢？
Because there are people who have ears but they don't actually hear.
因为我们很多人是有戴着耳朵，可是没有去好好聆听的。
I'm not here to say that every preacher, every pastor is perfect.
我并不是在说每一个讲道员、每一个牧者是一个完美的讲道员。
But what I do know is that we have a perfect God.
可是我想说的是，我也知道的就是我们有一个完美的神。
And He works in ways we cannot even begin to understand.
而且他的形式是让我们无法去测度的。
And anytime He appoints someone to be bringing us the word of God.
而他随时在差一个人来讲道，把信息带给我们的时候，
there's something that God has in store for us.
神的确是有更美好的东西要赐给我们的。
See, this is how we connect and commune with God as a people.
我们就是这样子以一个群体的形式与神有交流，与神有接触。
It is only in church that we can commune with God as a community.
我们只能够在教会，在一个群体里面才能够领受到神。
As a people, we cry out to Him.
身为一个同心合一的子民，我们呼求神。
As a people, we receive His word.
身为同心合一的子民，我们就领受他的话语。
So this is the second thing about what church is
about. 所以第二个重要的部分就是关于教会了。
Number one,
第一
church is a godly community.
什么是教会？教会就是属神的群体。
Number two, church is about this intimate communion with God.
什么是教会？第二就是我们就是一个与神有亲密交流的一个地方。
And lastly,
而最后呢
？Church is about commission.
教会就是蒙召的使命。
It come back in Matthew 18:20 again.
我们又回到那个简短的马太福音的经文哈。
Look at that verse.
我们来看一看，这里写：因为哪里有两三个人奉我的名聚会，我就在哪里与他们同在。
See, it says that we are gathered in His name.
这里就是写着我们相聚呢，就是奉耶稣的名。
We are gathering under God's authority.
我们是在神的权威之下相聚的。
We are gathering for His agenda.
我们聚会奉他的名，是因为有神要我们做事情。
To fulfill the purpose that He has.
来完成神要我们完成的旨意跟目的。
See, when we gather in the church, it is not about our own agenda.
当我们奉主的名在教会聚会的时候呢，不是说到是因为我有什么事情要完成。
It is not about wanting things to be our way.
而并不是因为我要这个事情完成是按照我自己的方式的。
But rather, it is to receive God's commission.
而是要领受到神所赐给你的使命。
What is this commission?
这个使命是什么呢？
It's defined as this.
它的定义就是如此。就是给予个人或团体的指示、角色或责任。
So every time we come to church, we hear a word.
所以每次我们来到教会了，就听到一段信息话语了。
With that word, we receive a commission to live out that word.
每次我们听到那段话语，其实我们就是领受到一个使命，要活出那一段道。
If we hear a word about holiness,
如果我们听到今天的信息是讲到圣洁的人生，
our commission is to repent and live a holy life.
而我们的使命就是要悔改而活出圣洁的生命。
If we hear a word about preaching the gospel,
如果我们听到一段信息是叫我们去传福音的话，
our commission is to go out and find every opportunity to share the gospel.
我们的使命就是寻找每一个机会来传福音。
If we hear a message about family,
如果我们听到的信息是教导家庭的，
our commission is to go home and be a better father, mother, son, daughter, husband, wife, so on.
那我们所蒙召的那个使命就是要回到家里成为更好的爸爸妈妈，孩子，儿子，女儿，丈夫，以此类推。
And that's why the Bible says it in James chapter 1 verse 22.
所以圣经里面就教导我们在雅各书第一章第二十二节，他们说，他是里面是说，你们要行道，不要只是听到，自己欺骗自己。
We must act on what we have heard.
我们必须听了道就要去行道。
But you know, there's a reason why we tend to not act on it.
可是很多时候我们听了道，我们有一个，我们不行道是有原因的。
Interestingly, James chapter 1 also, in the next few verses, goes on to give us an idea of why.
而其实这个雅各书的第一章接下来也有给我们看见了为什么我们不做。
Look at verse 25.
让我们来看一看第二十五节，雅各书第一章二十五节，但详细查考那使人得自由的全备律法，并且持之以恒的人，不是听了就忘，而是身体力行，这样的人必在他所行的事上蒙福。
Now I highlighted that important phrase for us.
我就特别标签了那个很重要的那一段话。
The problem with us, why we don't live out the word of God is because we forget.
我们很多时候为什么听了道而不行道呢？是因为我们很多时候听了就忘了。
Let's be honest for a moment.
我们要坦白一下。
How many of us remember what was preached last weekend?
大家都记得上个星期，牧师讲的道是什么吗？
What about the week before?
或者前一个礼拜的？
And the week before?
或者是三个星期前的？
Now, I think we may remember bits and pieces here.
我们或许会零零碎碎的记得一些要点。
But we might not remember the essence of the message.
可是我们可能不记得当时的信息的精髓是什么。
You know, sometimes we after the church service is over.
有时候呢，聚会结束了。
We'll say, oh, you know, oh, today's service, today's message quite good lah.
我们走的时候可能跟彼此的就说，哎，今天的信息讲得不错了。
Oh, today's message not very good lah.
今天的信息就一般般而已
了。Oh, okay only lah.
就 OK 而已了。
But and after that, it's almost like after the service is over, we kind of clear that out of our mind.
然后聚会完了之后呢，所有下载的在脑子里面都全部都清楚了。
And we forget.
然后就忘记了。
Even if for some people, maybe after the sermon, you took that there's 10 good things for you to take back.
或许你听完一篇道之后，你所学到的东西有十样很好的东西要学习。
Some of us maybe we need to back one thing.
或许有些人听完十个东西只带了一件东西回家。
But after a while, after the week goes on, we kind of forget about these things.
可是几个星期后呢，你就突然间就忘记了信息教的是什么了。
But what should we do then?
可是我们应该怎么做呢？
Just now we talk about the barren Jews.
刚才呢，我们就说到那个帖撒罗尼迦人。
And then they went back and they study the word of God to further deepen their understanding.
他们回去呢，他们就非常的辛勤的天天查考经文。
But I want to give us another part of scripture that teaches us what to do.
可是我要教导大家，圣经经文里面有教导我们应该听了道之后该怎么做。
In 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 7.
在提摩太后书第二章第七节告诉我们，你要思想我说的话，因为主必赐你悟性，明白各样的事。
And this is what I want to say to all of us as well.
而我就是透过这个经文想跟大家说的。
Whether it's me or any of our other pastors who are preaching the word of God.
无论是我讲道还是其他的牧师讲道。
Don't just receive it at this moment and then after the weekend, that's it.
不要单单在这一刻领受完了之后呢，过后就忘却了。
No, in the week, come back to it, reflect upon it.
在接下来的一个星期，你应该继续的去思想、去反省、去想一想，可能神会看见，帮助你看见各样的事。
Maybe one day in the week, your quiet time, use that time to re-listen to the message again.
或许你在接下来一星期做灵修的时候，你可以重温上周末牧师讲的话语。
And reflect on what was preached.
然后你可以去思想当时所讲的道。
And say, God, give me insight on this.
然后就求主给你悟性，去明白各样的事。
Maybe really, you know, you listen to the whole sermon and you just feel like you cannot connect all this. That you really feel like nothing for you.
或许你就重温回上个星期的讲道，然后觉得真的没有学到什么。
No, I mean when you heard the message, you really felt nothing connected with for you.
就或者当时你在听完了信息，到周末的时候，你觉得你没学到什么。
Go back and listen to it again.
要记得接下来回来重温这个信息。
Use your quiet time one day and just do it.
使用你的灵修的时间来重听一下。
And see, God, you know, when I just heard it, nothing quite connected.
你可以跟主说，主啊，当时在听的时候好像没有领受到什么。
But I want to reflect on what was said again.
可是我想去思想一下当时牧师讲的道。
And God, like your word says.
然后正如神你的话语里面说。
Give me insight into this.
求你赐给我悟性去了解到，去学那段信息。
I want to learn more.
我要学习更多。
I want to know you more.
我要更深的去认识你。
See, we must learn to live out this, whatever has been preached.
所讲的道，我们必须要学习把它给活出来。
Remember we talked about the ecclesia just now.
刚才记得吗？我们说教会的希腊文叫做 ecclesia.
What does it mean?
什么意思呢？
It means a called out people.
就是一个被呼召出来的集会。
We are called out from the world.And called to God's purpose.
我们是从这个世界里面被神所呼召的出来的，然后我们要进入神的应许跟计划的。
Whenever we talk about being called out, we often will bring us to 1 Peter 2:9.
每一次我们提到我们是被呼召出来的，我们都会被提醒到在这个彼得前书第二章第九节的这段话语。唯有你们是被拣选的族类，是有君尊的祭司，是圣洁的国度，是属神的子民，要叫你们宣扬那召你们出黑暗入奇妙光明者的美德。
See, the word of God doesn't just say that we are chosen.
神的话语不单单只是说我们被拣选。
He says we are chosen and all that, so that we may declare the praises of him.
他说我们被拣选的目的是要去宣扬他的话语。
We are called out from the world.
我们从黑暗的世界被召出来。
And now we are called to God's specific purpose.
然后我们就进入了神非常确切的那个旨意。
We have been commissioned to live out his truth.
我们就得到了，就蒙召了，有这个使命。
We've been commissioned to demonstrate the reality of God to the world.
神给了我们使命，就是要彰显他神的真实给其他的人。
And that is what the church needs to do.
教会就是需要做这件事。
We are not here just to listen.
我们的存在不单单只是要聆听。
Of course, it's important to listen to hear.
聆听很重要，的确。
But we're here to listen and do.
可是我们听了之后要行啊。
That's what James chapter 1 talks about.
就是刚才雅各书第一章所说的。
In fact, many times Jesus will say that also.
很多时候耶稣也会说
Go and do.
去行出来。
It's not just about talking about it.
不单单只是要把它给讨论出来，可是要去行。
So today these are the three things I want to share with us.
所以今天呢，就要跟大家分享教会到底是什么了。
What is church?
什么是教会？
Number one.
教会是第一。
Community.
属神的群体。
And if we call ourselves disciples of Jesus,
如果我们称自己为耶稣的门徒，
it is impossible for us to be a disciple yet not be part of a community of God.
我们是不可能是门徒，可是不在群体里面的。
Number two,
第二，
church is about communion with God.
教会是与神亲密的交流。
Yes, we can have the individual connection and communion with God.
是的，的确，我们可以单独与神有交流，有亲密的接触。
But it's in church where we as a people, as a community, experience that communion with God.
可是，在教会，我们就是一群子民，一个群体，与神一同的交流。
And lastly,
最后，
church is about having a commission from God.
教会就是有一个蒙召的使命。
And we must live that out.
而我们不单是听，我们也要行出来。
And you know, as we, on your screen right now, you can see all these three things.
而现在呢，在屏幕上你就看到这三个教会是什么的一个重要点。
These three things are not, separate entities.
这三个东西并不是分开来的。
But all three of them must come hand in hand.
而他们三个东西都是要携手前行的。
And I guess I can phrase it in one simple statement.
而我想说的是，我可以把这三个合而为成为一句话。
The church is a community of people living in communion with God, committed to His commission for the church.
啊，我们就把这三个来做造句了哈。教会是一个属神的群体，活在与神亲密交流的环境中，致力于完成教会蒙召的使命。
This is what the church is.
教会就是这个样子的了。
And all of us, we must understand this.
而我们每个人都必须理解。 这是教会。
These three things are so important.
这三个东西特别重要。
And today, maybe some of us, this is so relevant.
而今天对我们来说是特别的贴切的。
Because you've not been connected with the community.
因为你已经很久没有跟群体联系上。
Some of you say, you know, I can believe in Jesus, I can follow Jesus, but I don't need to be in community.
或许你说我相信耶稣，我认识耶稣，我追随耶稣，可是我不需要在群体里面。
I'll tell you right now, straight up, that's wrong.
我现在直接对着你说，这是错误的。
That's not what the Bible teaches.
圣经不是这样教的。
Some of us maybe you just feel like, you know, I don't need the church to connect with God.
或许你觉得我不需要教会才可以与神有交流。
But it's only when we have the church, we have the community, then we can connect with God as a community.
可是当我们有一个群体的时候，我们才能以群体的形式与神集体有交流。
And maybe some of us were comfortable to say, yeah, okay, I'll go to church, I'll be part of church just to listen and so on.
或许你就说，我好吧，我就来教会，我来教会听神的话语。
But we are told that we have to do it as well.
可是我们学习到的，我们不单单是听，我们也要行出来。
We have to live it out in every aspect of our life.
我们必须在生命的每一个环节、每一个部分把它给活出来。
This is what church is.
教会就是这样。
But of course, I know there are always struggles.
但是我知道一定会有挣扎的。
There are always difficulties.
也有困难。
And sometimes people will say this, you know.
有时候我们会说。
Well, Pastor, you make it sound so good.
哇，牧师，你讲的真好听啊。
You make it sound so easy.
你讲出来好像很简单这样。
But there are many reasons why people don't want to be part of church.
人不想属于一个教会是有很多很多原因的。
Because the church, we say, wow, can be very messed up.
因为你会觉得有时候连教会里面也是很凌乱的。
I see all kinds of problems in the church.
我看见教会里面很多种种的问题。
You say, wow, the church is supposed to love one another.
哇，你说这个教会是教导彼此相爱的。
Sometimes I don't see love.
有时候我在教会看不见爱。
I see kind of church, I see people talking bad about people, gossiping, betrayal, so on.
我看见教会里面有人出卖彼此，有人对着彼此背着彼此讲。讲坏话。
Now, I'm not here to say that the church is perfect.
我来到这里跟你们讲什么是教会，并不是在说教会的人是完美的。
If anything, as a pastor, I will say I know the church is far from perfect.
我身为牧者，我甚至在这里成长的，我能够跟你说，教会是不完美的。
But we learn something very important about how Christ sees the church.
可是我们学习到一个很重要的功课，就是如何基督是如何看待教会的。
I want us to look at Ephesians 5.
我要大家来看一下以弗所书第五章。
This passage we commonly use to teach about, you know, like husbands and wife and so on.
很多时候呢，这个以弗所书第五章我们是用来教导夫妻之间之道。
But in it we learn some important things about how Christ sees the church.
可是我们也在里面学习到如何基督是如何看待教会的。
Let's look at verse 25 to 27.
我们来看一看第25节到27节。做丈夫的要爱妻子，正如基督爱教会，为教会舍己，好借着自己的道用水洗净教会，使它圣洁，以便把圣洁、完美、没有污点、皱纹等瑕疵的荣耀教会呈现给他自己。
So interesting here.
这特别有意思。
Very often for all of us,
很多时候我们大家
we like to talk about how you know, Jesus loves me.
我们很喜欢说就是耶稣爱我。
Jesus loves us.
耶稣爱我们。
Jesus died for me.
耶稣为了我而死。
Jesus died for you.
耶稣为了你而死。
Jesus died for all of us.
耶稣为了我们大家而死。
But this passage gives us a different perspective also.
可是这段经文让我们看见了另外一个视角了。
Jesus Christ.Loves the church.
这里写着基督爱教会。
He gave himself up. He died for the church.
他为这教会来舍己。
See, that's a very important thing here, you know.
我们在这看到很重要的学习哈。
It reveals to us how God views the church.
经文让我们看见基督是多么的爱教会的。
It's how much he loves the church.
是多么的爱教会。
And it's even described that the church.Is Jesus' bride? Is his wife?
还甚至描述了对于基督来说，教会有如他的新娘，他的所爱。
The word used to describe the church is of such an intimate relationship.
你会看到基督跟教会之间的关系，如果说是新娘的话，那个关系是多么的亲密。
And this is important, you know.
而这是很重要的。
Because a lot of people, many people have said this.
因为很多人说过。
I love Jesus.
我爱耶稣。
I follow Jesus,
我跟随耶稣,
but I hate the church.
可是我讨厌这个教会。
I tell you something.
我要告诉你。
That statement cannot be said.
这句话不能说的。
If you say you love Jesus but you hate the church,
如果你说你爱耶稣，可是你恨这个教会，
then you don't actually know what it means to love Jesus.
那你就不理解什么叫做爱耶稣了。
Because Jesus actually loves the church.
因为耶稣是爱教会的。
Jesus loves the church so intensely.
耶稣他是多么的深入的去爱着教会。
The church is called his bride.
教会被比喻为新娘。
The church is called his wife. He loves the church so much.
他那么的爱教会，为教会舍己。
No, it's just like any married person here.
就有如任何已婚的人士。
If someone goes up to you,
如果有人来到你面前
，okay, and says, you know what, I really hate your wife or hate your husband.
就去到你面前说，哎，我很喜欢这个，我不喜欢，我真的很不喜欢你太太或者是你丈夫。
And you will have an issue with that, right?
然后你其实是有问题的。
It's the same thing, you know.
同样的。
We can say, hey, Jesus, I love you, but I hate the church.
同样的，你跟耶稣说，耶稣，我爱你，可是我不爱你的教会，我不喜欢你教会。
You will have an issue with that also, you know.
其实你也有问题的。
I say, but Pastor, how can you know? I mean, the church can be so messed up.
可是你会说，牧师怎么可能啊？这个教会真的是太多问题了。
Well, that's where we truly understand God's grace and God's love.
所以我们就要确确实实的理解到上帝是多么爱教会的。
God loves the church. God loves and Christ loves the church as his bride, not because the church is perfect, you know.
基督爱教会并不是因为教会是完美的。
He loves the church in spite of her imperfections.
就算教会是很不完美的，这里写教会还有皱纹呢，可是他仍然是非常爱教会的。
Yeah, go back, look at this scripture again.
你真的好好回去看一下这段经文。
He says he gave himself up for the church to make her holy, to cleanse her, and to be without blemish and so on.
他就是把用水用自己的道用水洗净教会，使他圣洁。
Meaning that the church is not actually without blemish.
也就是说，其实教会是并不是没有瑕疵的。
The church is actually not perfect.
可是教会是不完美的。
But he gave his life for the church to perfect the church.
可是他仍然愿意为教会舍己，使教会成为完美。
And that's how we see the immense and intense love that Christ
has. 所以就会看见了耶稣是多么的深爱教会。
That while the church is not nowhere close to perfect,
教会是绝对不完美的，还差得远。
He calls the church his bride, his love.
他称教会为他所爱的，为他新娘。
And that's why he prays for all of us to be one.
所以他祷告我们能够合而为一。
He prays for us to be the church that we have to be.
他祷告我们能成为他所希望我们成为的教会。
You know, this is just how much God loves us.
耶稣就是这么爱我们。
You know, it's like, it is in this church, it's in a church that you will experience a lot of problems.
在教会里面呢，你就会经历很多问题。
But at the same time,
可是同时，
in those problems, you can experience the grace and the love of God.
在这些问题里面，你就能经历到神的恩典还有他的爱。
In our imperfections, you see how God can work.
在我们的不完美里面，你就能看见神如何使用我们。
You see, if all of even us, we are not perfect.
就算是就我们一样，我们也不是完美的。
If you and me are perfect, then we never will truly receive the full extent of God's love.
如果我们是完美的话，我们是无法完完全全接受到神的爱的。
See, it's easy to love someone who's perfect.
你要去爱一个完美的人是很容易的。
What's hard is to love someone who is imperfect.
更难的是如何去爱一个不完美的人。
And the word of God says this.
而神的话语告诉我们
that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us.
那段话语就是当我们还为罪人的时候，基督为我们而死。
See, when Jesus died on the cross for our sins, it's not because we are perfect.
当基督为我们死在十字架上的时候，并不是因为我们已经完美了。
But because we are imperfect and because we don't deserve His love at all.
因为我们是其实是不完美，然后我们也不配得着耶稣的爱的。
Yet He still dies for us. He still loves us, showing us the extent of His grace and love.
然而他愿意为我们而死，这也让我们看见了他彰显的恩典，还有他为我们深深的爱。
If there's some of us here, we say that we want to follow Jesus, but yet we don't want to be part of the church.
如果我们当中有人说我要爱耶稣，可是我不要成为教会的一部分。
I'll tell you something.
我要告诉你。
Being church is definitely not something easy.
在教会里面不容易的。
But it's in church that you will experience the full extent of God's grace and love.
可是在教会里面，你才能够见识到、认识到、接触到神爱的长阔高深。
You know why you experience the full extent of that?
你知道为什么你才能经历到神爱的长阔高深吗？
Because you will need to extend that grace and love to people around.
因为你也要对着别人施恩典啊。
today.
今天
Let's be the church.
让我们成为那个教会
Let's be a part of it.
我们要成为教会的一部分
And despite our struggles.
就算我们有很多挣扎
Let's rise up to become the church that God wants us to be.
好不好？我们同心合一，兴起来成为神的教会。
Now, I'm sure that some of us here that connected, you've never responded to the gospel before.
我知道你们当中今天有人是第一次来参加聚会，或者是从未回应过这个福音的呼召。
Well, today's message is not just for the church.
今天的这个信息听起来像是给教会的，可是也不单单给教会的会众而已，也是给你的。
In fact, I think there are some of you that you have never responded that you.That Jesus is your Lord and Savior.
有些人你甚至从未回应过接受过耶稣成为你个人救主
And you're thinking that you want to follow Jesus.
而你心里面在想其实你很想跟随耶稣
But you don't want to be part of church.
可是你不想参加教会
Maybe you think the church is very fake.
或许你觉得这个教会很虚假
Or maybe you think that you don't need the church.
或许你觉得我不需要教会了
Well, today this message is for you.
今天这段信息是赐给你的
And everything I've said.
而我说的每一句话
You may think it's too good to be true.
你或许你会觉得有那么好吗
？But today I want to tell you this.
而今天我要告诉你
，What is true is how much God loves you.
真实的是什么呢？就是耶稣他有多么的爱你。
What is true is how much God loves His church.
多么的真实的就是耶稣基督有多么的爱教会。
That even though we are filled with blemishes,
就算我们充满着瑕疵
，Even though we have sinned,
就算我们是充满着罪的
，And the Bible teaches us that the wages of sin is death.
圣经甚至 教导我们罪的工价是死亡
This death is not just a physical death it's a spiritual death A separation of our spirits from the spirit of God
这样的死并不单单只是肉体身体上的死而是我们的灵魂与神永远的隔绝
But God did not want that
可是神不希望这样的一个结局
And so he sent his son Jesus to die on the cross for our sins
所以他就差派了他的独生子耶稣为我们而死
He took away our sins
他抹去了我们所有的罪
He gave us his righteousness
他赐给了我们他的公义
He perfects us
他使我们完成了完全了
and with that
而这样带着这样的一个信息
We are restored back to God
神就恢复了我们可以重新的去追随上帝。
We don't have to be separated from God because of sin.
我们不需要因为这罪而与神隔绝了。
But we can be reconciled to Him.
可是我们可以与神复合。
And the Word of God tells us this in John 3:16 and 17.
而神的话语在约翰福音第三章第十六节十七节告诉我们什么呢？他说：“神爱世人，甚至将他的独生子赐给他们，叫一切信他的不至灭亡，反得永生。”十七节。因为神差他的儿子耶稣降世，不是要定世人的罪，而是要叫世人因他得救。
Today, there's some of you you've never acknowledged Jesus as your Lord and Savior.
今天我们有朋友，你或许从未承认过、接受过耶稣为你个人救主。
It's no coincidence that you're here.
今天你听到这段话，并不是巧合。
It's no coincidence that a friend asked you to attend this service.
今天你朋友邀请你来听到，并不是巧合。
It's no coincidence that you've been part of a 幸福小组 for the last couple of weeks.
这几个星期来，你参加了幸福小组，绝对不是巧合。
God is calling out to you.
神在呼召着你。
And today, before I close this service,
而今天在这个聚会结束之前
，I want to give you an opportunity to respond.
我要给你这个机会来做回应。
If you'd like to respond, I'd like you to do this.
如果你要做回应的话，我邀请你跟着我这样做。
In a moment, while time, Paul is going to lead us in a prayer.
再过一会儿呢，保罗会带领你做一个祷告。
If you want to respond and say, Jesus, I want you to be my Lord and Savior.
如果你想回应，你想说，我希望耶稣可以成为我个人的救主。
Well, I want you to pray along with Paul.
你就可以跟着保罗一句一句祷告。
He will say this prayer out loud.
他会大声的把这个祷告读出来。
You pray out loud as well.
你一句一句跟着他大声的读出来。
Follow after him line by line.
一句一句的跟着读。
Say everything he says word for word.
他说的每一句话，你跟着每一个字逐个字的说。
And all the Christians let's pray together as well.
而我们所有的基督徒，我们都跟着一起来祷告，好不好
？So right now, I invite all of us to close our eyes and bow our heads.
所以现在我要邀请大家，各位弟兄姊妹，你们都低下头，闭上眼睛。
If you've never responded to the gospel,
如果你从未回应过这个福音
but today you say you want to declare that Jesus is your Lord and Savior.
可是今天你要领受好消息，你要接受耶稣做你个人救主。
Right now,
现在
as Paul leads you, you pray along with him.
保罗在带领你做这个祷告，你跟着他一起祷告，跟着我一起祷告。亲爱的天父，
亲爱的天父，
我感谢你，因为你好爱我。
我感谢你，因为你好爱我。
今天我领受你的爱。
今天我领受你的爱。
我感谢你，差你的儿子耶稣为我的罪而死。
我感谢你，
亲爱的主耶稣。
亲爱的主
我感谢你为我做的一切。
我感谢你为我做的一切。
我承认我是罪人。
我承认我是罪人。
我求你原谅我的罪。
我求你原谅我的罪。
我求你使我圣洁公义。
我求你使我圣洁公义。
我承认你是我生命中的救主。
我承认你是我生命中的救主。
而我要一生一世跟随你。
而我要一生一世跟随你。
谢谢你耶稣。
谢谢你耶稣。
Let's keep our heads bowed and eyes still closed.
我们继续低下头闭上眼睛。
I know that some of you responded for the first time.
我知道当中有朋友是第一次做这样的祷告。
And if that's you, here's what we're going to do.
如果你做了这个祷告，你跟着我这样做。
In a moment's time, we're going to count to three.
我要数到三。
At the count of three, I want you to say a very simple prayer.
数到三的时候呢，我要你做一个简短祷告。
And we're not going to lead you in this prayer.
这个祷告呢，我不会带着你做的。
We want you to say it yourself.
我要你亲自开口自己做这个祷告。
It's okay. We'll give you the words.
我会教导你怎么祷告，所以不用担心。
Just a few words.
几个字而已。
I want you to say this.
我要你说。
God, reveal yourself to me.
主啊，求你让我经历你。
God, reveal yourself to me.
主啊，求你让我经历你。
Now, I want you to say this for a reason.
我要你亲口开口说。
I want you to know that God hears you and not.Because someone is leading you in a prayer.
我要让你知道，因为你亲自做了祷告，上帝听到你，而不是因为有人带你来做的。
So, here's what we're going to do.
所以我们要这样做了。
I'll count to three.
我要数到三。
You say that simple prayer.
你就说这句简短的祷告。
God, reveal yourself to me.
主啊，求你让我经历你。
And after that, I'll pray for you.
过后我就祝福你，做一个祷告，好吗？
And if there's any of you just now, you didn't pray in the previous prayer.
如果刚才我们所做的那一句一句的祷告，你没有跟着做。
But right now, you know you need to respond.
可是现在你心中有感动，你要跟着我一起做祷告。
I want you to, you can pray and respond right now at the count of three.
数到三，你也可以跟着说这一句祷告。
So, let's do this right now.
所以我们现在做。
And I'll pray for you.
我为你做祷告。
One.
一。
Two.
二。
And three.
三。
Hallelujah. Lord, I thank you for every single person who responded.
主啊，我感谢你为这每一个做回应的朋友献上感恩。
All of you want to declare that your life will never be the same again.
所有朋友们，我要跟你们说，你生命不再一样了。
Because God is with you.
因为神与你同在。
And today He gives you this promise.
而今天他赐给你这个应许。
That you can be strong, you can be courageous.
你可以在凡事刚强壮胆。
Because He is with you.
因为他与你同在。
He will never leave you, He will never forsake you.
他不会撇下你，他也不会丢弃你。
So I bless you with this.
所以我要祝福你，这是神的应许。
In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray.
奉耶稣基督的大名祷告。
Amen.
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 Praise God.
赞美主。
Well, you can look up at the screen right now.
你现在可以看看屏幕了。
And I want to say for all those who responded, we're so happy for you.
我想跟第一次做这个回应的朋友们说，今天我们替你高兴。
You know, right now as you respond, you have become what we would call a spiritual baby.
今天你做了这个回应，我想比喻你成为一个属灵的一个婴孩。
Why do we say that?
为什么我这么说呢？
You see, a baby needs a family and a community to grow up and to journey through life.
因为一个婴孩是需要一个群体，一群家人帮助你一起成长。
Well, for you, you need a spiritual family and community to help you grow in your spiritual walk.
同样的，今天你是属灵的婴孩，所以你需要一群家人帮助你一起成长。
And we would love to be that family.
而我们希望有这个荣幸可以成为你的家人。
So if you responded in any way just now,
所以如果你刚才做了任何的一种回应
，We're going to put a QR code up on the screen.
我现在在屏幕上呢要放上这个二维码。
You can go directly to that website.
又或者是你可以直接去到这个网络链接。
We want you to get connected with us.
希望你会跟我们一起联系。
Because we're serious about being that family.
因为我们真的希望可以成为你家人。
And even if you didn't respond in any way,
就算刚才的两项祷告你都没有什么回应
，But right now you know you must.
可是现在你知道你必须这么做。
Well, go to this website.
去到这个网站吧。
Just connect with us.
跟我们联系上好吗
？Praise God.
赞美主。
We're going to close off worshiping the Lord in a moment's time.
我们现在要慢慢的要进入最后一首歌来结束今天的敬拜。
But as we do that, we also need to respond to the word of God.
可是我们也要回应神的话语啊。
Some of us here, you've been attending church services and everything.
我们当中有人，你一直在参加这聚会。
But you know you're not really part of the community.
可是你知道你并不是任何群体的一部分。
Today you need to make that choice.
今天你必须做出那个选择。
Say, God, I want to be part of the community.
说主啊，我希望可以成为其中群体的一部分。
Get connected with us, write into us. I'm sure you have got some of you are brought by a friend. Tell them you want to be part of this community.
我相信你有朋友带你来参加这些聚会的，所以跟他联系上吧。
Some of us were just comfortable saying, you know what, I just want to attend the service and everything, but I don't want to be part of this community.
甚至有人会说，我很开心参加聚会，可是我不希望成为群体一部分。
I want to say we need to repent of that.
我就说我们必须悔改。
Because that is not a Christ-like attitude.
因为这并不是属基督的一个态度。
That is not a biblical mindset.
这并不是一个属经文的一个思维。
There's some of us here, maybe what we need today, we need to say that I want to live out God's word.
或许今天你有感动，你说我要认真的活出神的话语。
I don't just want to listen, but I want to live it out.
我不单单只是要听到，我也要行出那个道来。
Ask God to help me.
求主帮助你。
There's some of us here as well.
我们当中也有人。
We come to church with a rather consumeristic mindset.
我们来到教会，我们有一个消费主义的一个心态。
We always focus on our own preferences or what we want.
每次我们只想到我们要的是什么，我们得到的是什么。
Focus on whether, or you know, whether was the service good or whatever.
甚至你也在一直在评估聚会好不好，讲道好不好，敬拜好不好。
But the issue is not what we prefer. The issue is not what we want.
可是更重要的并不是我们希望有什么，并不是我们要得着什么。
The issue is what does God want.
更重要的是要去考量到神，你从我生命中要的是什么。
Some of us, we need our mindset to be transformed.
我们需要改变我们的思想思维。
So as we worship the Lord,
所以当我们进入敬拜，
you respond in your own way.
你凭你自己的方式来做回应。
If some of you got specific prayer requests, put it up on the live chat.
如果你希望有人为你祷告，你可以写在我们的直播聊天室上。
If not, you can get connected with your cell leaders, your cell members, call them on the phone. They'll be happy to pray together.
又或者你可以发个简讯，打个电话给教会的朋友、组长、组员。
So right now, if it's possible, why don't we stand?
现在如果你可以的话，好不好站起来？
And as we do so, why don't we lift up our hands? Let's worship the Lord.
我们这样做的时候，我们也可以举起我们的手，一起来敬拜主。
So let's worship.
我来敬拜主吧。
主啊，我要跟随你，将我一生献给你。Wait 坚持一生不偏离。主啊，我要跟随你，将我一生献给你，求你用我做你的器皿，将你的爱分享。
感谢你赐给我们这段时间。
And we ask that during this season we find ourselves in,
我们求主啊，当我们经历现在这个季节，
we receive a fresh revelation of what it means to be in church.
我们就学习到、领受到在教会、在群体里面新的启示。
What it means to be your church, Lord.
如何成为主啊你的教会？
And Lord, we pray for all of us.
主啊，我们为着大家祷告。
That we will truly be your disciples.
我们真真实实会成为你的门徒。
We learn how to what it means to deny ourselves.
我们学习舍己。
And to focus on what it is that you want.
而专注于主啊，你想要做的。
And Lord, we know that the church is your idea.
主啊，我们知道教会是你的主意。
And we pray that we would live up to that calling.
而我们会活出那个呼召。
So Lord, help us.
所以主求你帮助我们。
I bless every single person here.
我要祝福每个参加聚会的弟兄姊妹。
Lord, we ask that you bless your church, this church.
求主祝福这个教会。
May we be the church you have called us to be.
愿我们可以成为主你所蒙召的教会。
Thank you for loving us individually.
感谢主，你爱我们每一个人。
And thank you for loving this church.
而我们感谢你主，你爱你的新娘，我们这个教会。
So we thank you.
所以感谢你。
We pray this in your name.
我们这样祷告，奉主耶稣的名。
Amen.
Amen.
Well, God bless all of you.
愿主祝福大家。
Thank you for joining us.
感谢你们来参加今天的聚会。
Have a great week ahead.
我们求祝福你们有美好的一周。
Stay safe.
保持安全。
And those of you who are coming for Chinese service next weekend, happy to see you guys.
下星期来实体聚会的，向往能看见你们。
All right.Bye-bye.
好，拜拜。